If for some reason chapters are not working, I'm pinning a comment with timestamps so you can skip to the part that interests you instead of watching the entire video. I honestly can't see any difference between high and low anti-aliasing, and since there is no performance difference, just leave it on low, just in case that somewhere, somehow you're going to get some more performance. Texture filtering can give you a decent FPS boost if you set it to low. That is my recommendation, since there are barely any places where you can notice a difference, and even that's only when standing still and looking for it. Trying to spot the difference between ambient occlusion, ultra and low is almost impossible in this game. Shame that there is no option to turn AO off completely, but in any case, just set it to low. Textures, as per usual, don't make any difference in performance until you hit the VRAM limit. If that happens, then drop them down. In other case, keep the textures on ultra for quality mode, or drop them to low for visibility mode. For quality mode, keep geometry on the highest setting. For visibility, drop it to low, since quite a chunk of distracting geometry disappears in the distance, which makes spotting easier, and 2% extra performance is always welcome. Reflections give you a really nice FPS boost when dropping them completely. Even in places where there is seemingly no reflection in sight, you are still going to get more performance. For visibility mode, turn reflections off, and quality, set them to medium, since it's almost impossible to tell the difference between medium and ultra. Can't see any depth of field in the game outside of start and end of the match screen, but in case I miss something, just keep it on low, even though I haven't been able to measure any difference. Definitely drop shadows to high for quality mode, since there is basically no difference compared to ultra. For visibility mode, set shadows to low to get some light back. And there are some shadows in the game that even on ultra have insane pop-in, and there is nothing you can do about it. Always set light quality to high. It doesn't affect sunlight, only some smaller sources of light. I wouldn't recommend setting it to medium or low, even for visibility, since some light sources might not render in the distance, making certain spots darker. Volumetric fog in this game doesn't give a lot of performance, but still something. For quality mode, set it to low, and good luck being able to tell the difference from ultra. Unless you prefer the clean look of no fog, then just turn it off. For visibility mode, turn fog off. Turning it off clears the game a lot, but in some places you lose bloom that fog gave you, making the game a bit darker but still way cleaner. So if you decide to turn volumetric fog off, I would recommend using black stabilizer to boost those darker areas. Maybe my eyesight isn't as good as it was back in the day, but I couldn't find any volumetric clouds, unless the normal ones are supposedly volumetric. Anyway, set it to low, since you are not supposed to look at the clouds but enemies. Ground cover quality is one of those settings that doesn't give you anything on some maps, but on others it boosts your FPS a lot. These numbers are averaged between all the playable maps. On certain maps you can get even 13% more performance with low setting. For quality mode, I probably wouldn't go below ultra, maybe go high. But I'm not sure about that. Visibility mode certainly dropped this setting to low. Tested Async Compute on a few different hardware configurations, and on average with the settings turned on, I could notice 3% higher performance. So definitely turn it on if you have a GPU that supports it. If your game behaves weird for some reason, This is the first setting I would turn off to see if that's what's causing the weirdness. Now, few things that won't make any difference in performance unless you're trying to run the game on integrated GPU or something equally weak. Terrain quality and decal quality, just leave them on the highest unless, like I said, you're really struggling with this game. Then effects quality won't give you any FPS boost per se, but I'm recommending setting it to low because it's going to give you better visibility in certain scenarios and won't make you drop FPS during messy fights. For quality mode, keep it on ultra though. There are a few more things, dynamic wind and flocking quality. I would set them to the lowest for the extra CPU stability. Then animation quality and simulation quality, keep on max unless your CPU is really being hammered. Blur and sharpening don't make any difference in performance, so adjust those to your own preference. Oh, and don't be afraid to use resolution scale. Here are some pictures. Can you tell which one is native resolution and which one is 75% resolution scale? Overall, with quality settings, you should get around 17% higher FPS without sacrificing visuals. Visibility preset is going to give you 35% more performance, and if you want to combine those presets with resolution scale, well, just look at the numbers. If you looked at the resolution scaling comparison pictures, you really should be tempted to drop that resolution a bit and use sharpening to clean it up. My recommendation would be somewhere between 90 and 75%, depending on your native resolution.